The vision in people with keratoconus is actually pretty unique. It's like having astigmatism amplified. And so this video, I wanted to go over how you see, what the vision is like if you have keratoconus. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, with the show that keeps your eyes healthy and your vision clear, and I do videos all about the eyes, educational videos like this one, so make sure that you're subscribed so you don't miss any of my future videos. Now let's talk about keratoconus vision. The cornea of the eye is a nice clear tissue right on the front part of the eye, and it's actually what you see out of. That's actually where people wear a contact lens, right on the surface of the cornea. And that cornea should have a nice smooth, round shape to it. Sometimes it can have a certain curvature to it, which can be called regular astigmatism. But sometimes, if you're unlucky, sometimes that cornea can actually progressively thin or bulge out, causing a cone shape, or keratoconus. And this can cause irregular astigmatism, which can cause more unique, blurry visual symptoms that I wanted to go over. A lot of the visual symptoms that people have with keratoconus are similar to people that have regular astigmatism or nearsightedness, farsightedness, where they just have blurry vision. Now, keratoconus kind of takes it a step further, where they have blurry vision at distance and at near and at intermediate, kind of like astigmatism can affect your distance vision, near vision, all around. When you have irregular astigmatism, it's a little bit amplified. So your vision is blurry, distance, near, intermediate, all distances can be blurry. Now, one common visual symptom that people with keratoconus will talk about all the time is how lights look, especially lights at nighttime. Headlights, street lights, when they're driving, the lights are almost distorted. And people with regular astigmatism might have the symptom as well, where they'll look at a light at nighttime and they'll see streaks coming out of that light. That's because of that curved shape of the cornea kind of stretches and bends that light a little weird. People with keratoconus have those symptoms a little bit amplified. So they might have that streak as well as other streaks coming from different angles, different locations. Also, they might have on top of that a little bit more glare or halos coming out of that light. And so that light is really distorted with multiple streaks, different types of halos that are coming from that light, because that cone shape on that cornea is just bending and distorting that light that's getting to the back of the eye. Along the same lines of those symptoms, people will also talk about having ghost images with lights, or maybe even normal images. Maybe if they're looking at a screen, or maybe a person's hand. You can use this as an example, but people with astigmatism might have that ghost image as well, where they're looking at something, maybe this hand, and they almost see another hand or a ghost hand that's right next to it. And people with astigmatism will have that, but people with keratoconus will have that amplified, and sometimes they'll talk about having triple ghost images, meaning they might have a ghost image coming out in one direction, and then they have another ghost image coming out in a different direction, or maybe they even have more than triple. They have many ghost glare images coming from one subject that they're looking at. So if you look at my hand, you might see multiple hands or ghost images coming from just this hand. And that'll drive people crazy because it looks like the vision's distorted. And this is also seen at night. Part of the reason why people have those light symptoms of glare and streaks and ghost images. And so it drives people crazy that have keratoconus. A good way that you can tell if you have astigmatism or keratoconus in large amounts is if you cover one eye and you still see that double image or that ghost image, there's a good chance that you have regular astigmatism or irregular astigmatism, keratoconus. Hey, just really quick, if you're finding value from this video, make sure you hit that like button. That tells YouTube that these videos are worth making. Also, if you want to check out my video about regular astigmatism, I'll put that link up there as well as in the description below. Now, here are some visual symptoms that are more unique to people that have keratoconus or irregular astigmatism. Because they have that amplified distortion, streaks, glare of light, sometimes that can actually cause light sensitivity because the light that's being bent into the eye is getting scattered and pushed everywhere. Sometimes it actually can bug people and actually cause them to be light sensitive. They can even be light sensitive at nighttime because all the headlights and street lights are just being distorted and pushed everywhere. It makes it very difficult not only to see, but sometimes it can actually cause the eyes to be light sensitive and sometimes painful. Keratoconus is one of those diseases that can progressively get worse, and sometimes progressively get worse at a faster pace. And so sometimes people with keratoconus will notice that their vision changes, or their prescription for their glasses or their contacts change pretty rapidly. Sometimes it's actually every 6 months, sometimes sooner. People need to come back and actually update their contacts or their prescription so they can see clearer. It's because that cone of that cornea is progressively getting thinner and coning out a little bit more. It's bending light a little bit more. And so the blur is getting worse and worse at a fast pace. Now, luckily, keratoconus has that age range of when it actually progressively gets worse and then it slows way down. But that's one symptom you want to look out for. If your prescription is constantly changing, your astigmatism is constantly changing, this could be a keratoconus symptom. Now, one thing that's annoying with keratoconus is that sometimes it actually can be difficult to get very clear vision, or clear your vision up with glasses or normal soft contact lenses. Because you have irregular astigmatism, that glasses doesn't bend the light correctly for the cone of your eye. Normal soft contacts don't like to fit or lay over the cone of your eye. And so sometimes you'll notice that to get the best vision, you kind of have to use specialty contacts, hard contact lenses that you can custom fit over that cone so you can actually see your clearest. People that have regular astigmatism tend to do fine with glasses or soft contact lenses that are made for astigmatism. People with keratoconus have a very difficult time clearing their vision up with normal glasses or normal contacts. Now, if you are having any of these symptoms where you have blur in all distances, lights have streaks or halos, or you're seeing ghost images, double, triple ghost images, definitely go in, get your eyes checked by your eye doctor, because you can definitely be seeing clearer depending on what condition you have. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope this video helped people understand what keratoconus vision is really like. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Stay focused. Make sure you check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video.